This video tutorial will show you how to change the printing pad on an Iconotech case printer. Before we begin, I would like to point out a few key features of the printing pad, the cylinder, and the hardware involved. The pad consists of the yellow top silk and a white felted fiber material on the bottom. The yellow silk will always be mounted on the outside of the cylinder with the fiber making direct contact with the cylinder. The silk has a printer manufacturing number on one end that identifies the leading edge of the pad. Both ends have a loop that is built in to capture the metal bar that mounts the pad to the print cylinder. There are two hold-on bars, one for the leading edge and one for the trailing edge. The leading edge bar has two holes drilled at an angle. These holes are designed to fit over the corresponding pins in the cylinder. Care must be taken to be sure that the angle of the hole matches the angle of the pin when installing the bar. To be done correctly, if you hold the bar parallel to your chest, the angle of the holes will be pointing away from you. The trailing edge bar will have elongated holes that also have an angle, and in this case, the holes are angled towards you so that the tension spring will seat properly. The tension springs are engaged and disengaged by lifting up on the spring and angling away from the shoulder bolt that holds them in place. Finally, before you change the pad, it is necessary to pump out completely and have a stencil on the old pad to help contain the ink as you roll it up. Once the pad is installed, run a normal automatic ink cycle while rotating the cylinder at 15 cartons per minute. To fully saturate the pad, 2 to 3 cycles may be necessary. In addition, blotting the new pad 3 or 4 times by running dunnage through the press will help to fully distribute the ink in the pad. And now, our service tech will show you how to change a pad on the fly.
In order to change the pad, the first thing we have to do is remove the load tray from the machine. We get out the new pad, and I like to have the serial number showing up front. So that'll be the leading edge, and I wrap it around this bar. On the print cylinder is the existing pad, or old pad, and I leave the last stencil on there just so that it's a little less messy to change. The idea is to change the pad, put the new pad on as I take the old pad off. And to do that, we're going to use the jog function on the panel, just like that. We'll jog the cylinder until the leading end bar is up at 12 o'clock. That's good. Release the stencil and release the bar. It's important now never to let go of the pad that's on the print cylinder, otherwise it'll leak out of the bottom, the underside. I put the bar into the new pad and I start rolling up the old pad. This is the only time that you'll have to do any kind of cleanup, so it's important to get that right away. I'm always remembering to pull up on the one that I have in my hand. I set the new pad in place, center it, and then I jog it a little bit. Remember to pull up. Hold it. Remember always to pull up on the one you're holding on to. Make sure you're centered. And then you just put a little bit of weight against it and you jog it around. Hold it. Making sure that it's always centered. Okay. Hold it. Okay, and rolling it up as I go, I'm going to come to the end of the new one here. Hold it. Okay, And then you're just going to take it all the way up to dead center. Right there. Roll the rest of that up. Disconnect the trailing end bar. Get rid of our old pad. Make sure that it's on tight, never to let go. And then we'll wipe this end up. This is relatively clean compared to what it could be. But this is the only chance you have to clean up whatever is here. Insert the trailing end bar into the loop. And of course today it doesn't want to open up. There we go. Insert the springs into the slots of the bar and pull the springs back simultaneously and over the shoulder bolt heads to seat. The bar is sitting on top of the screws. You got to pull it down to where it sits below the screw heads. Right there, just like that. Now, it went on a little crooked, so we're going to straighten it out. Show you how that works. Release the springs again. Take the springs out of the bar. Lift it up and jog it over a little bit so we can get it centered. Recenter the bar. Put the springs in the loop. Pull up and press it down behind the screw heads. Clean up any extra ink that you might have around. We'll jog it around. And you can see that whatever residual ink was in the cylinder has already soaked through the pad surface, which it always does. Looks pretty clean. And we're ready to ink it up. Close the cover, set it up to rotate less than 15 RPM, and then start the ink in pump. The cylinder will rotate by itself if you hold the button down for more than 20 seconds. That's it.